Hey, how y'all doing out there? All right, today we're going to be doing some basic marker tips and tricks. And I thought it'd be a lot of fun to try out a few different, popular markers that we have on the website here. And these are markers that you would find yourself using in a variety of graffiti type situations. So what I have here is divided amongst these two types. I have gravity feed markers and valve actuated markers. And for those who already know this stuff, just bear with me because there's always someone new learning this stuff. So we want to make sure that everyone is up to speed on these things. Now, before we move forward, let me just double check here. How's the audio sounding, y'all? How does the audio sound? Does it sound good? Give me a thumbs up or thumbs down on the audio and we'll move forward here. Just want to make sure you hear me well. Good? Good? Okay. Awesome. All right. So let's move forward. Okay. So anyways, we got two main types of markers. We have what is, a classic marker. Let's start with the pilot here. Okay. Cause this is the type of marker that you'll probably find like an office supply store or, Home Depot or whatever. And they're pretty common. They've been around for years. They're also called zebra pens. As you can see, it's got the stripes on it. So, hence the name. If you ever find one of these, make sure you get the one with the yellow-green label. Don't get the one with the blue label. I mean, you can get it if you want, but that's like their eco-friendly version of it. And as we all know, that they never write quite as well as the originals do. No substitute for xylene, people. No substitute for xylene. You know what I'm saying? So let's start with the pilot. So the pilot is a gravity feed marker, and what I mean by that, Let me get some gloves on. Gotta get my ninja gloves going. All right. Who's ready for their rectal exam? You guys ready for your exam? This will be a marker exam, though. So this is a gravity feed marker. And the reason why it's called that is if you open it up. What up, Fry Guy? How you doing? What up, Skaz? What up, Gunk? I hope you guys are doing good. Okay, so check this out. So this marker has a wadding inside. It's called a tampon. It's got a tampon in there. And that gets soaked up with ink, as tampons are wont to do. And you fill it up with ink. And then the nib here, as you can see, it extends into the tampon. And so when you screw them together, give it a little bit of a shake, the ink will flow down to the nib with gravity. Using the power of gravity, think about that. You're harnessing the power of the sun to get the ink to flow through your marker. Think about that. That's a big deal, man. It's a big deal. So anyways, what up, Hannah? Yeah, we're talking about tampons. Okay, Stu Art 30 says, flip the nib over for a fresh nib. Yes, Stu, we were just about to get onto that, actually. Thank you for bringing that up. So on these markers, the nib is dual-sided. See that right there? So if you wear out the nib on this side, you just flop it right over, and you got a fresh nib. Now, keep in mind when you do that, pull it out here. See this little pin right there? There's a little pin. There's a little pin in there. Should be a pin. Oh, there it is. See it right there? Notice how the pin isn't centered. So when you're ready to flip it over, just make sure you move that pin over a little bit and you'll get a much more even situation there. So, all right, let's go ahead and put that back in like that. Chuck says a bashed nib is the best though. I feel you, brother. I feel you. Flaring out the nibs is dope. I do feel that. So anyways, so that is a gravity feed marker. Now let's take a look at a valve action marker. See what we got here. Oh yeah, I swapped the nib out of this off of something else here. I don't even know what's on there. It looks like speed flow or something. Anyways, so this is a valve action marker. I think this is an Art Primo hit and go. And this has, let's see, programmed evolutionist says crispy nib is best. Everyone's got their own flavor. You know what I'm saying? So this is a valve action marker. And what that means is it has no tampon. It's just an empty vessel to hold the ink. And as you pop off this part here, that's the valve. Check it out. You actuate the valve by pushing the nib, and you see it moving right there. So there's a little seal that opens up when you push the nib in and gets the valve flowing. So in order to get this nib saturated, am I screwing this on the right way? In order to get this nib saturated, you have to depress it. Now this is a dry nib. I had pulled it off of something else. I probably should start with a fresh nib here, but you know, what are you gonna do? Anyway, so in order to get the marker going, just press the nib to get the ink flowing to the nib, and you will get a nice juicy marker. Now what's really cool about these is in order to fill it, you don't have to open the front. You can just open it from the back. See, you got a couple cat eyes in there. Do kids play marbles anymore? I doubt it. It's a good game though. All right, you got a little seal on the back. Mohammed says, remove the valve and let the ink flow. Actually, no, Mohammed, if you do that, it won't work on these type of markers. I think you're confusing that with a mop. On a mop, you can take the valve out. It will be leaky, but you can do that. On these, if you take the valve out, see right there? The fry guy wants to know what type of marker I like more. See, without the valve, the nib just falls into the marker. You feel me? There we go. Won't work. So always make sure to keep the valve in your marker, like that. I know, poor nib. How you doing, Glash Monster? Now, someone had asked what my favorite marker is. That's a really good question because I like so many type of markers. When it comes to just average tagging, I'm always using a valve marker myself. But maybe it's just out of habit because I still like the classic Pilot marker. And you know, if you're on a budget, you can't really beat them. What are these, like $3? I think they're like $3. Remember that movie with, what was that movie with the paper boy? Want my $2. Give me my $2. Basically, a valve action marker, you know, is made with a lot more parts than one of these. So we can make these for a lot cheaper. So you can get one of these for like $3. This empty is going to run you probably about $5. So there's a price difference. You can really juice up the nib on a valve actuated marker, which is really nice. But it does eat up a lot more ink. The tampon style marker tends to not eat up as much ink. You can get a lot of tags out of it. So there's some differences between the two. So let's go ahead and start messing around with them, right? Because isn't that why you guys are here? I think that's why you guys are here. So, Mohammed wants to know if I like paint or ink markers. That's a good question, Mohammed. There's a few different types of ink formulas that you can put in a pen, and they're all technically inks. But some are more painty, and some are more ink-like. All of the tampon style markers or the gravity feed markers. So I got a Magic Ink here. I got some Sakura SG7s and I got a Pilot Jumbo. These all feature the same type of tampon inside. So these would all require a very like runny, stainy ink, you know, like an alcohol based ink or a xylene based ink. Let me grab some inks here real quick. Just bear with me, yo. Just bear with me. Okay, I'm just grabbing some inks over here. Let's see what else we got here. We got some inks on deck. All right, so we got some Magic Ink right here. We got some other inks over here. All right, so with a gravity feed marker, you can only use a dye-based ink, okay? So you can't put paint in it. So like the On the Runs use a paint. If you put a paint in this, it'll just get all chalky and it won't work very well. You know what I'm saying? Because it needs to flow out naturally. And the paint doesn't do that because it's a pigment suspended in a solvent. The dye is going to be a dye powder is blended in with the solvent itself. It's miscible in the solvent, so it can naturally flow through the nib. So make sure whenever you're filling up any of these type of markers to use a actual dye type ink. But the thing is you can use a dye type ink in a valve action marker. For example, I have this one right here. This is Art Primo Hit and Go, 30 milliliters. This has a dye-based ink in it right now, but you could also put a paint in it if you want to. For example, I hope this is helping some people out. All right, so I got some paint right here. This is the same marker. Because it has an open shut valve, you could put paint or dye in each one of them and you're good to go. So that is the advantage of these type of markers over these. you're limited on your paint or your ink on one of these versus the other. Let's go ahead and close this up. The other thing to remember too is dye-based inks do fade much quicker in the sun than pigmented-based inks. Although dye-based inks, like what's in here, are very stainy. So if someone tries to buff over a dye, it'll tend to bleed through rather easily versus a paint, which just gets painted right over. It doesn't bleed through. So they're give and take, you know what I'm saying? It's like not, they each have their advantages and disadvantages. This is very destructive, by the way. So there's a few different differences on the two there. So let's go ahead and start playing with some of these markers. Should we start with the tampons first? Let's start with the tampon markers. Let's do that. Okay, let me move some of these guys over and we'll get over to the other ones here. All right, this is a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to this. I'm glad to be here with you guys. I hope you're doing good. And, you know, stay up, be awesome, be your own grandpa. You know all those good things I say. Oh, my hat just got stuck on the camera there. All right, so let's take a look at these first three. Now I have, looks like I have some doubles here. We'll just put that one back. Just have it on deck in case the other one dries out. Let's get the brown bomber out of the way here. I do like the brown markers though. So, all right, so we have a Sakura SG7. We have a Magic Ink. Hold on, let me get this over here. This is the MGDT1. I always forget that. It's too technical, I guess. The Pilot Super Jumbo. And those are the three main types. All right, so the SG7. Let's take the caliper here. It has it's rated at 15 millimeters, but it actually looks to me to be about 17 millimeters wide. This is rated at 15 as well too. And it also is about 17 millimeters wide. I think this is rated as 11 millimeters. 10. Well, no, I'm kind of squeezing it. Yeah, 11 millimeters. So this is 11 millimeter square chisel. We have 17 millimeter flat chisel right there. So they are different types of nibs. So first let's do a quick little line with each of them so you can see what they look like. All right, so here's the Pilot Super Jumbo. As you can see, it creates a nice, even 11 millimeter line. Quite nice, actually. All right, and here's the Magic Ink, which is MGDT1. Sorry about that. We'll do a line with that too. Much broader line, very clean, rather nice. Look at this beautiful piece of art I'm making. I am an artist. What is art but creating culture? You know what I mean? It's using a medium to express yourself, whether it's doing video online or just drawing squiggles with your marker. Okay, all right, here's the SG7 Sakura. Let's go ahead and do a line with that. Sorry, I only got it in purple. Although this purple probably stains really good. I bet it does. Look at that. Oh man, that is a smoothie. That is a smoothie booty. It smells nice too. It's quite a nice odor. I would say the Pilot and the Magic Ink are the two most odoriferous of the two. The SG7 is not quite as stinky. So if you're in the back of the bus, maybe the SG7 would be a better choice. Don't do illegal graffiti, kids. That's against the law. All right, I'm gonna do a couple tags here. Let's do a couple quick tags. Let's see here. Can I hit up Alien? Alien, that's a good name. I like that name. Oh yeah, I wanted to hit up Sens again. He wanted a YouTube hit off, so let me hit up Sens really quick. I hope I'm not blocking the camera there. The way this is set up is like the most uncomfortable setup, really. let me try hitting it from this way. I hit it from the side, I hit it from the back, I hit it all around, I hit him on the track. All right, let's hit up Elvis. This is a much more natural way for me to tag. tag, but I can't see the camera screen. That's the only other thing. I think I need an assistant to read off tag names for me. All right, that was dope. I really like that, Elvis. Hold on one second here. Let me see here. Just bear with me, guys. Let's see if I can pop out this. Just bear with me here really quick. All right, now I can see the screen. Oh, that's a great idea. I'm going to do that in the next live feed. All right. Let's see here. Hey, why isn't the stream working? Okay. It's a learning process, guys. It's a learning process. It's a learning process. All right, let's hit up since. Big since in the house. That's a nice one. Ooh, crow. Big crow in the house. You know, I got some crows in my neighborhood, and they're super aggressive against the local raccoon population. Usually around like 5 or 6 p.m., the raccoons come out, and the crows just go nuts. They do not like the raccoons at all. It's really funny. They beef like that. They really beef heavy. If I was a raccoon in my neighborhood, I would not mess with them crows. All right, let's... Oh, look, I'm putting the wrong cap on here. Good job, bro. Good job. All right, let's hit off some names here. Let's see. Sicko, big sicko. Big sicko. Yeah, that's a much more natural way for me to do this. I like this. Okay, that was the magic ink marker. I really like that. Loke, L-O-C, Loke. Big Loke in the house. What up, Loke? What up, Loke? I already hit up Gronk in the last video. I see you try to get in there again. I see you, Gronk. I see you. Oh, Beast? Beast. The Beastmaster. That's a good name. I really like Beast a lot, man. That's a really good name. All right. Let's play with the pilot, too. We got to give the pilot some love. What do you guys think? Should we give the pilot some love? I think so. Ooh, I cannot keep up with that feed right there. Oh, KVK, I guess that's your crew, huh? Okay. Let's hit up KVK. I like that. I like that. That's a good name. I like that. Alright. And the stream goes nuts for hit-offs. Don't forget, guys, we still got to do the valve action markers. We still got to do the valve action markers. Alright, let's hit up Dice. Big Dice in the house. Ooh, that's a dope name, brother. That's a dope name. Oh, is that Butter? Is Butter in the house? I love Butter, man. He's the homie. Young homie. There you go, Butter. You keep doing those little Butter characters, homie. Keep it up. Keep it up. All right. So that was a lot of fun. We did a lot of work with these markers, but I think we need to move on to the valve actions. All right, let me get my kit together here, boys. Boys and germs. Boom. All right, let's talk a little. Oh, what up, Rake from Israel? What up, homie? How you doing? Hope you're doing good out there. All right, let's take a look here. Let's take a look. All right, so there's a few different types of valve markers that you can use. And this is just some randoms. I grabbed the masterpiece, of course, because it's just such a crazy marker, and I thought we should use it. So, oh, excuse me, burp there. All right, so first up, why don't we play with the uni broads? Now, these are some very well-loved unis, so I think the nibs are a little bit worn, but that's okay. We'll use them anyways. Let's take a look at this one here. Okay. So that is how the nib looks in stock form right there. It's a chisel nib. I want to say it's about 8 or 9 millimeters. Let's change my perspective here. Let's see what we're looking at. So yeah, about 8 millimeters. This is the same type of nib too, but as you can see, look at those Japanese unis. Aren't those dope? This one has the nib backwards. You see how the nib's all flared out right there? Now, sometimes people do this on purpose, and I did do this on purpose on this one. It makes the nib more mop-like. Eventually, it gets pretty broken down, so you gotta reverse it and put it in again like that. And to do that, you know, you just flare the nib out. You can rub it on some concrete. You can do a few different things. But either way, you know, it's whatever you want to do. It's whatever you want to do. So anyways, let's move these guys. And first, let's play with the unis. Now, the unis are a oil-based valve action paint marker. They have a metal barrel, and they are refillable, but Uni does not sell refill ink for these markers. Why? I do not know. Now, when they go empty, you can fill them with whatever you want. When I empty them out, I usually use like a mixture of like Speed Flow and Garvey and a few other things and make a little concoction with it. It's a lot of fun, but they are wonderful markers. They basically last forever. If you damage the nib on yours, we do have replacement nibs available, just so you guys know. Let's go ahead and prime the nibs on these. Woo, juicy, baby. Now these old school paint markers, they're not like the Molotovs. If they're full and you juice the nib, they will flood out sometimes. So just be careful, okay? Okay, let's see here. We got Sayer in the house. We got Toner, Big Toner. What up, Toner? I hope you're doing good, homie. We got Slave. Hope that's some S&M shit. Just kidding. Not my forte. Okay, let's see. Derp. Yeah, let's hit up Derp. I hope that's Derperino. Hope you're doing good, homie. Haven't talked to you in a while. What up, Derp? Now, keep in mind, these are paint markers. So when you use them, they won't feel dry to the touch right away. They'll still be quite wet. They'll feel a little sticky and wet right there. You see that? So just be careful when you use them because they are sticky, they are wet, and they will make a mess. They will make a mess. Oh, Chaos from Ireland. Chaos. There you go, Chaos. What up, homie? Shout out to all my Irish homies. Shout out to all my Scottish homies. Shout out to all my English homies. Shout out to all the homies out there in the United Kingdom. What up, what up? Okay. Someone right, Doofus. That's a good name, actually. That's the kind of name that you would see on the street, and then like your mom would see it. Yeah, he's such a doofus. Yeah, Doofus. Nice name, Doofus. Why don't you write on your own stuff? Oh, Debo's in the house. Debo's in the house. What up, Debo? Big Debo. All right, so that's the Uni Broads. So as you can see, they are valve actuated. You push the nib to get the ink flowing. All right, we'll do one more tag with this black one right here. Snake. 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 I think this one's starting to get a little out of ink, but that's okay. You see how it is. Trust me, unis are dope. Anyone who says otherwise has never used a uni, or they just don't know what they're talking about. All right, let's see what's up next. Let's see what's up next, party people. Let's see what's up next. All right, up next is the Molotov Speed Flow marker. And am I on the camera here? Can you see me? Okay. Up next is the Molotov Speed Flow marker. And this is the 667PI, which is Molotov's 600 series markers. Now these feature a 15 millimeter nib, and it's a true 15 millimeter. Hopefully the camera catches me right there. I can't see myself here, but it is a true 15 millimeter nib. So it's a little bit smaller than the tampon markers, but it's valve actuated to get the ink flowing. You know, just push the valve in. Now, Molotov uses what's called they call it a Flowmaster valve. And of all the markers I've ever used, these don't overkill when you know, like the Uni does. It doesn't overkill and overflood with ink as easy. It does sometimes, but it's very, very rare. But they're wonderful markers. They're really, really wonderful markers. Okay, let's see here. Banana. I'm going to write hand banana. That's what I'm going to write. As you can see, these markers are very juicy. Probably one of my favorite tagging pens. There we go, hand banana. Oh, did you guys see the Carl I did on Instagram? I hope you guys saw it. All right, let's hit up Post. Big Post in the house. What up, Post? I hope you're doing good out there. Let's see. Spool, S-P-O-U-L. I kind of caught that. I think it's S-P-O-U-L. Is that right, Spool? So anyways, going back to the ink that's in this marker, it's an alcohol-based ink, but it's highly, highly, highly staining. It works really good in any type of valve action marker. Not all alcohol-based inks are the same. The pigment quality in this is without peer. It has like a really nice, almost like a metallic black look to it. And the cool thing too is when you buff over the SpeedFlow ink, it bleeds through with like basically a piss yellow stain. It's very, very stained. Really good stuff. I can't say enough good things about the Masterpiece markers. They come in a huge variety. They're one of my favorite markers. Definitely, definitely. Let's see. Man, beer is blowing me up. Should we give beer some love? Okay, beer. We'll give you some love. It's like I need to prime my nib, though. Oh, wait, you know what? I didn't have it on the sweet spot. Let's give beer another hit off here. There we go. Much better. Oh, that felt way more buttery. Notice the difference between the two on here. As you use these type of markers, the nib kind of starts to develop a sweet spot on it. So if you favor one side, it's going to give you a much more smooth write than if you use the other side. Well, I just primed it. You can see it here. So make sure you get your sweet spot going there. Make sure you get your sweet spot going. Oh, the homie from Thailand hit me up. What up, man? How you doing? Excuse me. So anyways, that was the Molotov Masterpiece. I rather enjoy it. I hope you did too. All right, let's see what's up next. Yo, did I just lose the cap for that? Oh, there it is right there. All right. Got me worried for a minute. All right. All right, now this is a classic paint marker. This is the OTR 160, also the 060, which is the larger version of these. Now they were kind of like basically the first like mass market graffiti pen. And you know, some people really like them, some people don't. It's an alcohol-based paint that's in them. They are 15 millimeter nibs. I like the metallics, but I like them with a little bit of dye mixed in. So let's do that right now. So let's see here. Let me try and get a good angle. It's difficult because I can't see the camera while I'm doing this. I need a better setup. But it'll work for now. All right, let's see here. All right. There, that's better. Okay, so like I said, this is a 15 millimeter marker. To fill it, you have to unscrew the marker like this. The nib's still good? Oh yeah, it works. Okay, unscrew the marker like this. See that? Pull the valve out. Oh shit, it's out of ink almost. Well shit. We'll get a couple tags out of it. I guess we'll have to go heavy with the dye. No problem. So these alcohol-based inks, you guys ready? You poor guys, you guys ready? Alcohol-based inks are compatible. Alcohol-based paints. There we go. Let me spit it out correctly. The alcohol-based paints are compatible with the alcohol-based dyes. So you can mix them together and you can create some really cool effects here. Hopefully it won't spill out. Okay. All right, make sure that's on there nice and tight. Don't want it to leak on me. Look at that little guy, a little stubby chubby. Okay, give it a good shake. Bam popped. Do you guys like that last video where I put the plate tectonics up? I thought that was pretty cool. All right, so there he is. Look at it shaking up. It's got like the metallic and the dye mixed in together. Now, normally I do this when it's about half full, but it was like almost empty. So I think it's gonna be mostly dye that comes out. But whatever, we're just having fun. Okay, A-C-V-Y. Whoa, that's a hard one. Okay. Ooh, getting drippy on me. All right. As you can see, you can get like a cool dual tone, with this. Latin, L-A-T-A-N. Once it starts to break in, you're gonna get some really, really cool effects. Now you could also use this as like a fine art tool if you're doing like graffiti art on canvas or whatever. You can get some really cool effects with that. Hopefully I'm not blocking the light here. Oh man, I'm really liking that a lot. It looks really cool. That is wicked cool, wicked cool. All right, let's see who else. Let's see. Oh, Big Rez, what up, Rez? I hope you're doing good, man. Big Rez in the house. Man, I had to write that like sideways. Sorry, the Z came out a little bit ganked. Nah, it actually looks better. I think I redeemed myself with that extra bar. Elysium. Oh man, he wants me to write Elysium. Whew, that's gonna be hard. I don't even know if I can do that. Let me get out of my comfort zone real quick here. I just misspelled it. Did I misspell it? No, I did. Let me know if I misspelled it. I can redo it. All right, let's see what else is here. Let's see. Damn, hella people from the UK on here today. That's dope, man. That's really, really dope. Crumb. I feel like Crumb is always hitting me up for hit offs, but never gets them. So let me hit up Crumb really quick here. God, I love this. So dope. All right, we're going to get up nice and close on this in a second here so y'all can see how it looks. I think Glash Monster's really gonna like this. Y'all, you could be putting this on your canvas work, yo. Oh, also follow Glash Monster on Instagram, at Glash Monster. Very good artist, very talented. All right, let's get up nice and close. All right, E-Tac, I got you, homie. I got you. All right, let's take a look at it real close here. Getting off the tripod here. So this is how it looks when you mix the dye with the paint. As you can see, it's very messy. Extremely messy. But it's cool. Look at where the dye like fills in. Wherever there's a streak, the dye comes in to fill in for the rest. And what's dope is this dye will create a stain. So if they buff over this, you know that dye is bleeding through. Like, look at this part right here. If this was vertical, if this was on a vertical wall, this dye would go bloody. Oh, Surf Ninja. This is coated paper. So it's fairly non-porous in a sense. It's got a special coating on it. But yes, it's not quite the same as paint, but it's still quite nice. But it does have a coating. It's not regular paper. Wait, am I talking? I thought I had that turned off. Hold on a second here. All right, sorry. I hope you weren't hearing double audio, man. Oh my God. Clone Zone wants to know where I get the dye. You can use any old dye, but I'm using OTR Flow Pen Ink dye right now. Flow Pen Ink right now. All right, let's get. See, I have the feed over here on my MacBook going, so I can take a look at your guys' comments as I'm writing. But I had the volume up, so I kept getting this weird echo, and it was making me trip out, I guess you can say that. All right, let's go ahead and move on. So remember, alcohol-based inks, mix them with the alcohol-based dyes. Try to focus on metallic paint with a dye, and I think y'all will really enjoy it. So remember, metallic paint pens with dye, and you will get that cool little effect. Good stuff, man. Good stuff. All right. Let's move. Woo! Stuck to the table. Go on there. Go on. Look at them having a pile up back there. Having a pile up. All right. Let's move on to the next one. What's next? All right. Let's use the Art Primo Hit and Goes because I really like these a lot, man. So remember, these markers have a valve action. Let me pull this up here. They're valve action markers. So when you push the nib in, the ink flows through. Now this one has a mix of Flow Pen Ink, Garvey, and some powdered dye powder. My hat got stuck on there. Right now I'm using methyl violet, and we're putting that in markers. It's a staining powder, and boy does it stain. I got some on my hand yesterday and it got everywhere. You can use, if you're really in a pinch, you can use Rit dye powder. I've never really messed with it myself. I usually use like the methyl stuff, but you know, I've heard of people using Rit dye of all kinds of dye powders. You can use whatever. You're your own grandpa. All right, let me plug the power back in on this thing. Okay, so let's get cracking. All right, let's hit up some fun names. Some really fun names. Let's see. I'm going to hit up Butt Munch to get started, just to inspire you guys. Hit up Butt Munch. Man, I love these markers. They're so flowy. Let's see. Oh my God, it's going too fast. Oh, you want me to see hit off MF Doom? Okay. Now that is a talented rapper right there. That is a talented rapper. Let's see, hit up. Mike Cock? Oh yeah, that's a great one. Mike Cock. Remember, world's best graffiti writer, Mike Hawk. Mike Cock can do tags bigger than you. My cock is way up more than you are. My cock has the biggest, baddest thing around. My cock can rock the block. Feel that. All right, let's get to it. What's that you want me to write? Camel toe? Okay, camel toe. Gotcha, gotcha. Camel toe. Oh man, this is a good one. Dude, that camel toe's dope, dude. I would actually write camel toe. I might actually write that. I might actually do that. Okay. Oh, Mike Hunt. Oh yeah, I forgot about Mike Hunt. We don't really have room for him, though. We don't really got room for Mike Hunt. Let's see. I got room for one little thing over here. Oh, let's hit up Tekashi 6ix9ine. The hottest rapper in the world right now, right? They hating, but he's popular. He is. He is popular. Look how beautiful this marker flows. You know, I took one of these to Berlin, and I just went nuts with it, man. I was tagging on rough surfaces, smooth surfaces, all kinds of surfaces, and this marker just took the beating. And when I got back from Berlin in the United States, the nib was so worn down. It was worn down to about right there, but it still worked. Still worked really, really good. We got replacement nibs, by the way, if that ever happens to you. But anyways, let's move on to the next. Let's move on to the next marker here. Let me cut this off real quick. Let's see here. Check my messy desk here. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, there we go. Man, that is a piece of art right there. Look at that. Let's take a look at this here. We got Butt Munch, we got MF Doom, we got Mike Hawk, and Camel Toe. A little Camel Toe at the end there. I'm gonna keep this one. I think this one's going on the wall. Oh yeah, check that out. We just got these in from Germany. Look at these. Aren't these cool? They're from Molotov. We can be getting them on the site pretty soon. I just happened to see this real quick. All right, let's see here. Where's the rest of that paper? Oh my God, what is going on over here? Oh, that's funny. I think I'm running out of roll paper. All right. Let's get cracking. We got to get back to work. Guys, we got to work on this together. This is a project we're doing. It's called being your own grandpa and doing your own thing. Not listening to haters. People will hate on you guys. Just know that. You just do your thing. All right, let's see here. All right, let's do one last marker. And what will it be? Oh yeah, this is what we're doing. All right, y'all ready for this? All right, let's see here. Let me get situated. Oh, and the next YouTube video I'm going to be doing with spray paint, just so you guys know, we'll be doing the Rick and Morty video. Rick and Morty, because y'all asked for Rick and Morty. I'm gonna do Rick and Morty. I'm gonna do it for you. I'm gonna do Pickle Rick and maybe a Rick piece or something like that. Because y'all been bugging me about it. You're like, yo, did someone do the Rick and Morty? So we'll be doing that with Iron Lock in the next video. So keep your peepers peeped for that. All right, let's get cracking. All right. Okay, up next. Excuse me. Excuse me, my apologies. Okay, up next we have the Molotov. We have the Molotov masterpiece right here. Look at this. Now here's the thing. The masterpiece is unlike any marker you'll ever see. Nobody's ever made a marker like this. It's a very unique design. It's compatible with these same barrels. But they're kind of a pain in the butt, just so you know. So you have to be careful when you open them, because see, the nib kind of pops out. But you can use that to kind of bash it back in. But where are you going to find a marker like this? There's just no other marker like this. You're just not going to find it. Let's see the nib size of this thing. Look at that, 60 millimeters, right on the money, man. 60 millimeters wide. Now, some people might say you're using this big marker because you're compensating for an inadequacy or something. You know, there's always some type of inner meaning in these things. Maybe we just like to destroy things with beautiful art. We create and we destroy at the same time. It's a beautiful thing. So anyways, let me get over here. These are 60 millimeters wide. You can use them with a variety of inks. I have here some Molotov Covers All ink, which I think will work just fine in this marker. They are very thirsty, so if you buy one of these, make sure you get plenty of ink and actually carry the ink with you when you're out writing. I would save this marker for very strategic placement, or if I was doing fine art graffiti, like on a canvas or on paper or whatever, because you know, people do that, surprisingly. You might not know that, but people do that. So make sure that you, make sure that you have plenty of ink on deck. I'll go ahead and fill that up here. Now, don't overfill it. That is the other thing. You don't want to overfill it, because the valve does go into the marker body. So make sure you don't overfill it. Okay. Hold on. Let me hold that there really quick. Astrofats wants to know when we're bringing Smash back. Smash is essentially out of business, and I don't know if we can bring it back. I want to. I don't know. Sometimes a good thing has to end. Okay, so like I said, see, the valve sits in the marker, so make sure you don't fill it too much, because if you fill it too high, when you go to put the nib on, all the ink will spill out, okay? So make sure you don't overfill it. Go ahead and screw the barrel on here. That's a, it goes on clockwise on this marker, okay? L. Coop Johnson says, say hi to Italy. Okay. I'll say hi to Italy. Oh my God. Sorry, man. Let me try that again. Too close to the top, I guess. I think I had mixed a different kind of ink in here, and the nib is not liking it. So let me go get a fresh one really quick. Sorry about that, guys. See how there's a little bit of blue in there? I had added something to it, and I think it messed up the nib. So give me like 5 seconds, okay? 5 seconds. Sorry about that, guys. We'll just start with a fresh one. I had put something in there beforehand. I saw it as I was filling it. Oh yeah, take a look at that right there. See this right here? Look, I put something weird in there. The thing is I have so many markers just laying around in here. I don't remember what was in them, and then I start adding other stuff, and then whoops. Looks like I bunked this one. The cool thing is we got extra nibs. I don't have time to get another nib right now because we are live, baby. We are live. It's okay. It's okay, Glash Monster. I'll put a nib on it later. It's what happens. You know what I mean? It happens. So let's get a fresh bad boy. I try to be fair to these markers. You know what I'm saying? I try to be fair to them. That wasn't a fair representation. Not the marker's fault. That was my fault. Okay. See? They fall out. That's the only thing I find annoying about these is the cap design. So just be conscious when you're taking them off. But like I said, they're a lot of fun. They're a lot of fun. They don't really need to be shaken, but I'm just going to go ahead and shake it up here. Let's see here. Do you want to see it up close? Do you want to see the nib get charged up close? I think you want to see that, don't you? You want to see that. Let's see here. Let me take the camera here. That's something you might want to see up close. We got nib people here. We got nib people. They like to see this stuff. You know, the internet takes all types. You know what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and fill it up here. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, there we go, there we go. Oh. Now that's more like it. Now that is more like it. Look at that. Oh yeah, baby. Oh man, I did that right in the middle of the paper too, so now I gotta roll it back up. It's all good. It's all good, homies. It's all good. All right, let's go ahead and get cracking with this. Everything for the cause, homies. Everything for the cause. All right, let's see here. I'm not going to be able to do a lot of tags with this, just so you know. I'm chasing girls with the big breastises. The big breastises. Who isn't chasing the girls with the big breastises? Okay. All right, let's plug in the power. That way we don't have any issues. All right, let's get cracking here. Tomorrow is a better day. That is good advice. You're having a bad day. Okay, don't get that on the wall, Green Ranger. You're gonna get that on the wall. Okay. All right, let's hit up some short names. I saw a Den over there. Big Den. Oh, yeah, now we're talking. Now that's what it's supposed to look like. Oh, 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 yes, yes. Look at my arm. Look at my arm. All right, let's hit up Stu. Big Stew in the house. What up, Stew? I hope you're doing good. Can we just take a second to admire this, to just appreciate what we got? This is like a can of spray paint, man. Seriously, man. Okay, let's hit up OKC. As you can see, I'm only writing the short names right now. So no long names, sorry. Big OKC in the house. K-A-Y, basically crew hit offs right now. So if you want your crew hit off, now is the time to do it. WTM. This is the other thing that bugs me about these, is the nib will fall out sometimes, so be careful. You know, it's just one of those things, man. I mean, it is what it is. It's the world's widest marker, you know? You know, I mean, you can buy a Bugatti Veyron, and I guess it's the world's fastest car, you know? But if you try to take it off-roading, it's not going to do too well. You know? there are limitations as well. Now, if you notice this, the marker's not streaking. There's actually a piece of paper under here, just so you know. Try to be fair. There's RTK right there. As you can see, it's happening all along the same part of the marker. So that's not a streak. That RTK came out clean, though. I do like that. 64. He wants a 64 tag. I guess that's the neighbor of 69, right? that's a good one. That's a good one. Ding Ziapong, I hit up 64 for you, brother. I got you, my man. I got you. I got you. All right. All right. All right. Who we hitting up next? Who we hitting up next? AK-47. Avtomat Kalishnikova, number 47. You know, they're building motorcycles now. The guys who make the AKs, they're making motorcycles for Putin. Hopefully, they'll come to the U.S. They look really nice. They look like a really nice bike. You gotta be kidding me, man. This marker is just nuts. Nuts marker. Okay, what's next? What's next? What's next? Did I hit up Aztec already? I thought I already hit that up, but I'll do it again. Shout out to my Aztec homies. What up, Aztec? There you go, there you go. N-A-G-A. 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 I gotta get that paper off of it.
It's annoying me, man. It's annoying me.
Alright, alright, alright. We'll do two more tags and then we'll be done. CNS. Big CNS in the house, and XO. Are you sending me hugs and kisses? What was that Simpsons episode? Amanda hug and kiss? When Bart would call the bar, he'd call Moe's Tavern. He's like, "Hello, I'm looking for Amanda hug and kiss." And then Moe would be like, Is Amanda hugging kiss here? I'm looking for Amanda hugging kiss. That's so good. Ah, poor Mo. He was so depressed. He was like the original emo. Oh, man, that's good. All right, I think that's enough. That's enough, yo. That's enough. All right, let's close out the video here. Let me get all the markers lined up here. Let me get them all lined up. Boom! Marker madness, marker madness. Let's get nice and low here. You guys remember Amanda Hug and Kiss? You guys remember that? Tony says, I like turtles. Oh, Ralph, man. I love Ralph, too, man. He's a great, great character. All right, so this video is closing out. I just want to say thank you so much for... Oh, we forgot the crink. Sorry, KR. We'll catch you on the next one. All right, so we have the Masterpiece. We got the Masterpiece. We got Sakura SG7. We got Uni Marker. We got Sakura SG7. We got Magic Ink Marker. We got Empty Hit and Go, we got Magic Ink Marker, we got Pilot Super Jumbo, and we got other Hit and Go right there. That's all the markers we used today. And remember, some markers are valve actuated, so to get them flowing, you push the nib like that. Some markers have a tampon, and they flow the ink out with gravity. You're using the power of nature. You're harnessing the power of the sun. Anyways, I love all these markers. I don't think you'd be disappointed by any of them. In fact, brown is my favorite color of all. Because I am the brown bomber. But anyways, I just want to say thank you guys for watching. I had a lot of fun with y'all. I think we should do a live black book next week. We'll see what my schedule's like tomorrow. Maybe I can do it tomorrow, but most likely be working on the Rick and Morty video. But I just want to say thank you guys. I love you guys. Remember, get out there and paint. Be yourself. Don't worry about what the haters say. Just do your art or do your graffiti or do whatever it is you do. Because remember, graffiti is whatever you want it to be. It's also what everyone else wants it to be. But it is mostly what you want it to be. So be happy with what you do. Be proud of yourself. go sell yourself and have a good night and be safe out there. Love you guys. Talk to you later.